Hi, I am Valder Beebe. I am the host and the visionary of That Celebrity Interview.
Dr. Leslie Cho, welcome to the Valder Beebe Show, broadcasting live in Dallas, Texas. Welcome, welcome.
Thank you so much for having me.
Well, you're here to talk about obesity and your heart, and I think we really need to have this conversation. So give us about our lack of a knowledge about obesity putting us at the risk of a heart attack.
Right. A lot of times we think of, you know, weight, and we think of a number on a scale, or we think of a dress size or a pant size. But weight really has a tremendous impact on our longevity and the quality of our life. Weight increases our blood pressure, our cholesterol, our risk of diabetes, which then, of course, leads to things like heart disease, heart attack, stroke, sleep apnea. But it also increases things like cancer risk and having arrhythmias. So it really is a very, very important risk factor that we need to control.
February is American Heart Health Month, and I'm so glad we're talking about this. And the Cleveland Clinic did a survey. Could you give me some findings from that survey?
Yeah, so the finding of the survey is that many Americans know that weight is an important risk factor, but very few Americans are doing anything about it. And it's not surprising given the fact that, you know, majority of Americans have been on a diet. You know, it's up to as much as 80% of Americans have been on a diet. And you know, they've been on a diet, maybe they lost a little weight and then they gained it all back and then some. And then there's so much information out there, sometimes just really bad information out there about weight loss and the type of diet. And I think oftentimes people are incredibly discouraged. And so not many Americans are doing enough to lower their risk by trying to lose weight and, you know, adopt a good nutritional lifestyle and exercise program.
Dr. Leslie Cho is the medical director of the Cleveland Clinic's Women's Cardiovascular Center. Comes well qualified to talk on the subject. Dr. Leslie, how do you find out if you're obese? Because people say, oh, and they tell you all the time, I know I'm overweight. People say that all the time. But how do you really find out, you know, authentically, if you're, you know, if you are obese or overweight?
So, I mean, there's a simple tool out there called the Body Mass Index. You can do it on, you know, on your computer. I think you can do it on your phone. You can find out what your ideal body mass weight is. Now, so in some patients, it's a little bit off. Like if you're, you know, if you have nothing but pure muscles, it's a little off. But for a majority of us, it's a very accurate measurement of your obesity. I think another important, crucial place for you to understand your risk is with your doctor. To go to your primary care doctor, get your blood pressure, your fasting glucose, and your cholesterol level checked, and get your BMI checked. And have a good discussion with your physician, a team approach to trying to lose weight and exercise right.
For anyone who's listening today and they want to start a weight loss program, I think it's a good time because, you know, it's still resolution time. They want to get started. Where can they go online to get more information from the Cleveland Clinic?
Yes, they can go to theclevelandclinic.org/loveyourheart. For a ton of information, completely free, on diet and exercise, and how to lower your risk factors.
Doctor, I want to thank you so much. And if you could give them one advice, personal advice, because you've done this for quite a while, what would you say?
I mean, I think the number one advice I would say is you have to want to do it. You have to want to do it, and you can't think of it as a short-term diet. It's a long-term commitment. This is something we model for our kids. We model for our grandkids. It's a lifestyle change. And if you think of it as a diet, it's a short-term thing you just stop doing after it's over. But that's not how this works.
Oh, Dr. Leslie Cho, that was good advice. I want to thank you. She's the director, once again, of the Cleveland Clinic Women's Cardiovascular Center. Thank you for being my guest on the Valder Beebe Show. You probably saved someone's life. Thank you.
Thank you so much for having me.